Batteries are an important part of any off-grid system and a significant financial investment. All batteries degrade with usage, from your phone battery to your car battery, so they do need replacement one day. However, how you use them goes a long way in how long they last. So today I'm going to show you how to avoid unnecessary degradation and show you how to get the most out of your batteries. Battery types. At GridFree we offer two battery types. The first one is gel batteries. These are a sealed lead acid battery. And the second option is our lithium option. These are lithium iron phosphate batteries. Both of these react differently to the same care, so the information about them is going to be a little different. In short, the gel batteries are expected to last around 3 to 5 years before replacement, and the lithium more than 10 years. So what causes unnecessary degradation on these batteries? The main causes of battery degradation are over-discharging, sitting partially charged, incorrect temperature, bank imbalances, and overcurrent draw. Each of these will affect gel and lithium differently. First up, let's discuss over-discharging. This is when you discharge your batteries too much. The threshold for too low for gel is about 50% of their full capacity, and for lithium, this is about 80%. These recommendations are designed to give you the best balance between lifespan and usable capacity. For example, if you were to discharge a gel battery down to 25% rather than 50% on each cycle, you'd probably cut your battery's lifespan in half. So how do I prevent accidental over-discharging? For gel batteries, you need to set your inverter to stop outputting power when your batteries get to 50%. In an ideal world, you'd simply set the correct voltage cutoff corresponding to 50% of your battery bank's capacity. However, battery voltage is not the only indicator of state of charge. It also depends on how much power you're drawing from the batteries at the time. So, if you are drawing a lot of power, your batteries will hit that voltage cutoff before they're at 50% state of charge. When it comes to our lithium batteries, over-discharging doesn't do quite as much damage to their lifespan, and you don't have to worry about the settings as much. This is because the inverter will shut them off at 20% by default, and the battery itself has a safety cutoff at 10%. These batteries will also give you an accurate percentage of charge, like your phone, so you don't have to worry about interpreting voltage. Leaving your batteries partially charged. This is where you leave your batteries sitting at less than full charge for a sustained period. If you do this regularly for multiple days, the damage will add up over time. If you leave them quite low, it will only take a couple days for this damage to occur. The lithium batteries are quite tolerant to this, but they still will be damaged if you leave them very low for a couple months. How do I prevent this? Well, the first and best preventative measure is sizing your kit correctly. If you have a big enough system, your batteries will get fully charged virtually every day. But if you do have a kit already and you are finding that you cannot get your batteries to full most days, you need to upgrade the system, add in a backup generator, or see what you can do to cut back on power. If your batteries will be stored for an extended period of time, such as before installation, you should make sure you store them at full charge for gel batteries and about 75% for lithium batteries. It's recommended that you top up the gel about every 3 months and the lithium about every 6. Incorrect battery temperature. Like any electronic device, batteries also have an ideal operating range for temperature. If you go outside these ranges, you can cause some pretty severe damage to them. So, for the gel batteries, we recommend staying within 15 to 35 degrees Celsius, and for the lithium, this is 0 to 45 degrees Celsius. These batteries can operate outside of these temperature ranges, but we don't recommend it. It will reduce their lifespan. Imbalanced batteries. This is where the individual batteries in a battery bank end up at different states of charge. This is bad for all batteries involved, because the worst one drags all the other batteries down and usually only gets worse itself, if not corrected. This is only an issue for gel systems, as the lithium batteries communicate between each other to prevent this. Battery bank imbalances usually occur from a couple main things. The first is running batteries of different ages in the same bank, and the other is running loads off of only one or several of the batteries in a battery bank. For example, running a DC load, such as 12 volt lights, from only one battery. If you want to run 12 volt loads, you need to get a DC to DC converter, which draws power from your entire battery bank and then steps it down to 12 volts. And if you do need to upgrade your battery capacity, we recommend doing this within 6 months at the most, Otherwise, you will have batteries of very different ages. Overcurrent. This is where you draw too much current for your batteries over a sustained period, or way too much in a very short period. This is called shorting your batteries out. Shorting is usually caused by crossing the leads or dropping a metal tool across the two battery terminals. You'll know when this happens because you'll hear a pop and see a spark. It's important to be careful when working around batteries, because even shorting them for a small amount of time can cause some serious damage. For the case of sustained overcurrent damage, you're only going to see this when you have a very large appliance running off a very small battery bank. For most of our inverters, this isn't going to be an issue, but if you are unsure, please check with us. So, if you have any more questions about batteries, or you just want to have a chat about off-grid stuff, please get in touch or check out the website. We're more than happy to help.